All right, good Saturday evening, everyone. I'm meteorologist Eric Burris in the First Alert Weather Center. A rocky road across our area early today as we saw lots of showers and thunderstorms developing across our area and just kind of bubbling, really. We saw a tornado warning. We also saw multiple severe thunderstorm warnings. The good news, we did see lots of reports of hail, but no injuries and no damage. Trough of low pressure sitting to our south, and it really extends all the way up the coast into the mid-Atlantic states, but it's just supplying a lot of moisture, and our area of the state is continuing to see that moisture. Up in central Florida, they're actually getting a bit of a drier forecast for your Sunday, but for us, we stay in the soup. That means showers and thunderstorms once again will be developing. Out into the tropics, believe it or not, we're tracking a tropical storm, the first tropical storm of the 2012 season, even though the season doesn't begin until June 1st, but Tropical Storm Alberto was named, and as of the 5 p.m. advisory, which did name the storm, the winds were up to about 45 miles an hour. Now, the storm is drifting slowly to the southwest here at about 3 miles an hour. It'll get picked up and just kind of push off the coast. It should stay off the coast of the mid-Atlantic. Winds are expected to top out at around 50 miles an hour, a strong tropical storm. It should stay just off the coast of Norfolk and then basically fizzle out as a tropical depression off the coast of the Jersey Shore. Not expected to become a hurricane, but it certainly is something rather interesting of note. As a matter of fact, it's the first May system since Tropical Depression 1 back in 2009. That being said, it's the first named tropical storm since Arthur, Tropical Storm Arthur, back in 2008. Now, it's also the earliest forming tropical storm since Tropical Storm Anna back in 2003. Just on average, it seems like every 10 years or so, by the way, we do see a tropical cyclone, whether it be a depression or a storm, form during the month of May, every 10 years or so. So this just happens to be one of those times. Tonight, back here at home, 71 degrees, a few storms, and then they'll slowly be fizzling out. For tomorrow, another day of showers and storms. The further south you live, it looks like the better chance of rain you'll find. 85 degrees, our daytime high temperature. On the area waterways across South Florida, seas a little bit rougher, not much, just a little bit. Seas running 2 to 4 feet. Inland waters nice and smooth. Winds out of the northeast at about 5 to 10 knots. Now look at your forecast for us. Starting off at about 71 degrees, 8 a.m. The sun is up 75, about 85, 86 degrees in the afternoon for your Monday. Another setup with showers and thunderstorms likely will wake up to 71 degrees, climb to 84 degrees in the afternoon. Showers and thunderstorms continue for your Tuesday. For your Wednesday, actually looks like more widespread storms for your middle part of the week. And then we continue to see those storms likely all the way into Friday and Saturday of next weekend. Of course, you can always track those storms 24 hours a day right here on WPBF.com. Have a great Saturday evening.